Hello guys, today we are going to start up with a new poem by the name Ethics, written by Linda Paston. So ethics means the moral values of human conduct. So ethics means the values we have, the moral values we have. Okay, so to differentiate between what is right and what is wrong are the ethics. Okay, so to differentiate by ourselves, which is wrong, which is right, which is moral, which is good for others, which is good for us. So that are called as the ethics. So this is the poem written by the poet Linda Paston. So before we go to the poem, let us see some relative information about Linda Paston. Linda Paston was born in 1932 to a Jewish family in Bronx, New York. So she born the year she born was 1932 to the Jewish family in New York, and she graduated from Radcliffe College and received MA from Brandeis University. So she has been awards and honors to her credit. So she was a beautiful writer, so therefore she have got the rewards and the honors. Pushcart Prize, Dylan Thomas Award, Alice Fady Castagnola Award, the Best Hawking Prize are a few to name. So these are all the above prizes or awards honors she have received. She served as the Poet Laureate of Maryland. So she has impressed everyone by her writings, so therefore she is considered as the Poet Laureate, and now she lives in Potomac, Maryland. So she was born in New York, but now she lives in Potomac, that is in Maryland. I'll read the poem, see for the pronunciation and comprehend it. In ethics class so many years ago, our teacher asked this question every fall. If there were a fire in a museum, which would you save? A Rembrandt painting or an old woman who hadn't many years left anyhow? Restless on hard chairs, caring little for pictures or old age, we would opt 1 year for life, the next for art, and always half-heartedly. Sometimes the woman borrowed my grandmother's face, leaving her usual kitchen to wander some drafty, half-imagined museum. 1 year, feeling clever, I replied, why not let the woman decide herself? Linda, the teacher would report, eschews the burdens of responsibility. This fall in a real museum, I stand before a real Rembrandt, old woman, or nearly so, myself. The colors within this frame are darker than autumn, darker even than winter. The browns of earth, though earth's most radiant elements burn through the canvas. I know now that woman and painting and season are almost one, and all beyond saving by children. Let us now understand this poem line by line. So in this poem, Linda Paston, the poet, is describing about the ethical situation wherein one become in dilemma. Okay, so dilemma means what decision they has to take. For example, you have come across a situation where you do not able to decide what you have to do. Okay, so you will become in a 50-50 situation. Either you has to go right or left. 50-50 you will become. No? Such kind of dilemma the poet has elaborated in this poem about the present and the past. Okay, and how the children will get up the maturity along with the going days. So let us see the poem. In ethics class so many years ago. Many years ago, in the ethics class, our teacher asked this question every fall. Okay, fall means the season called autumn. So in this season, the season will change from summer to winter. Okay, so it will, the from summer to winter means the cold will start and then leaves change their color to yellow. So during that season, so The author's teacher asks a question every year. So the teacher of the author asks every year she asks a question. Okay, what is the question? If there were a fire in a museum, which would you save? A Rembrandt painting or an old woman who hadn't many years left anyhow? So the poet is giving the situation if. It means the imaginary situation. Okay. So you people also imagine that you are in a museum which has caught a fire. Okay. So which one you will save? A Rembrandt painting. Okay. Rembrandt is a person who is a Dutch painter who is known for his self-portraits and biblical scenes. Okay, what is there in the Bible, that scenes he created in his paints. Okay, such a creative person Rembrandt is. So one side you have the Rembrandt painting and other side you have a old woman which will die after some days. Okay, so she is so old that her life is very less. So the teacher has given a situation to the children. So what you will choose? The painting of Rembrandt, okay, which have been preserved from many years, from centuries, or you will save the lady who have very few days. So restless on hard chairs, caring little for pictures or old age, we would opt 1 year for life, the next year for art, and always half-heartedly. Okay, so this question is being asked from so many years, every autumn. So these people, what they do? So 1 year they will choose for life. Okay, that is 1 year they will answer it as they will save the old lady. The next year they will opt for the art. Okay, the next year they will say that they will save the Rembrandt painting. Okay, so irrespective of knowing the value of the painting and value of the life of the old woman, so these people choose 1 year the painting, the other year the old lady, because these children don't have the experience of life, right? So they don't know how difficult it is to make a painting and they don't know what is the value of life. So therefore, they will choose 1 year life, the other year the art, and always they half-heartedly, means they are not clear about their answer. Okay, and they do not have the valid reason why they are choosing only one. So therefore, half-heartedly they will answer the question. Sometimes the woman borrowed my grandmother's face. Now Linda Pastan is saying that, so the old woman who is in the museum, so she imagines that old lady as her grandmother's face. Okay, so she is comparing the old lady to the grandmother's face. Leaving her usual kitchen to wander some drafty, half-imagined museum. So Linda Pastan is imagining, okay, comparing the old woman with her grandmother who has left her kitchen wander. Okay, so means who have not arranged her kitchen properly and looks drafty. Okay, so drafty means uncomfortable. Okay, so unorganized kitchen will be uncomfortable, right? So like that, the old lady has left the kitchen which looks like the museum. Okay, in museum so many different kinds of things are arranged, no? So like that, she have left the kitchen like that. 1 year, feeling clever, I replied, why not let the woman decide herself? Now, so every year this question is being asked. Okay, so what question is being asked every year? That if you are in a museum and that museum has got caught fire, then which one you will save? You will save the painting of Rembrandt or you will save the old lady which has less days. Okay, so 1 year, cleverly, Linda Pastan replied that, why not let the woman decide herself? Okay, so we can go and ask to that old lady that we can save her or we have to save the painting. Okay, so after a few years, Linda Pastan was able to give the answer to this, and during the passing days, now the poet is matured, right? So therefore, she have replied cleverly that why not we let the woman decide herself. Linda, the teacher, would report eschews the burdens of responsibility. So the teacher will tell about the how to avoid the burdens of responsibility. So the life, okay, so every passing day, our every passing day is like a lesson to us. Every day we will learn something and we should have some certain levels of responsibility on this. Okay, so till now it was the imaginary fall. Now the poet Linda Paston is now coming to the present, that one day she will this fall. Okay, so the coming fall, fall means autumn season, okay, winter season. So this fall in a real museum, I stand before a real Rambridge, old woman, or nearly so, myself. Now, the imaginary question was that, now the poet wants to realize it in the real life. Okay, she is trying to enhance the differentiation between what is real and unreal. Okay, till now what we discussed was the imaginary thing. Now the poet wants to feel it in reality, how it will be. So she is saying that, so this fall what she will do, she will go to the real museum, stand in front of the real Rambridge painting and old woman, or nearly so, myself. Okay, so either old woman is there or not, she will be there. Now she is saying that she can say that the colors within this frame are darker than autumn, darker even than winter. The browns of earth, though earth's most radiant elements, burn through the canvas. Okay, now see, the poet is mature to understand the value of life and art and have the ability to make a decision in the difficult situation. Now when she is standing in front of the Rambridge painting, now she is able to differentiate between the real life. Okay, I know now that woman and painting and season are almost one and all beyond saving by children. The poet is matured enough to understand the painting and also the seasons and also the value of life of the old woman. So this is all about the maturity and the ethics, in what situation, what decisions we have to take.